When we talk about health and diet, most people know that controlling the ingestion of sugar is essential to maintain weight and avoid diseases. So when seeking a healthier diet without too many excesses, most people turn to artificial sweeteners. And then come the doubts. Are sweeteners safe? Can they cause cancer? Since 1940, studies link the use of artificial sweeteners with cancer in lab mice. In the 70s, this led the U.S. to put warning labels on anything containing saccharin, similar to cigarette packages. Researchers analyzed more than a decade's worth of health data from 102,865 French volunteers. The study started in 2009, and the researchers analyzed data from that year until January 2021. Every 6 months, the volunteers are asked to keep a dietary diary. They write down everything they eat and drink during the day, and even take pictures and save labels for determining portion sizes. Thanks to these annotations, the researchers had a decent register of which and how many artificial sweeteners one would consume in an average day. They found out that the consumption of artificial sweeteners was associated with an increased risk of cancer. More specifically, researchers found that people who consumed any kind of artificial sweeteners had a 13% to 14% higher chance of developing cancer than those who didn't. Researchers analyzed three common sweeteners, aspartame, acesulfame potassium, and sucralose. The cancer rates were 15% higher for frequent consumers of aspartame and 12% for those who rarely consumed it. Aspartame was more associated with an increased risk of breast cancer than the other sweeteners, with a 22% higher chance for frequent consumers. Cancer rates were 13% for frequent consumers of acesulfame potassium and 12% for those who rarely consume it. Sucralose seemed to have the lowest association with cancer. The rates were only 4% for frequent consumers and 3% for those who rarely consumed it. Nowadays, the FDA allows 6 artificial sweeteners in the U.S., which are widely used in industrialized foods. Saccharin was found in 1879 and can be found in fruit juices, sweets, jams, and cookies, especially those with low-fat labels. Aspartame was approved by the FDA in 1981 and is frequently added to sodas, energy drinks, desserts, sweets, gums, and products for weight control. Acesulfame potassium, approved in 1988, is used in sodas and protein shakes and can be added to medication to make them more palatable. Sucralose was approved in 1998 and is used for most of the same things as aspartame. Neotame and advantame, approved in 2002 and 2014 respectively, are not as common yet. The first 4 are allowed by the European Union, too. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.